Okay, this is version 2 of the Howard Johnson patent replication here. Now I should point out these NEOs here, if this was more accurate, these should be about the size of these magnets and how far they come across to here to cap these off. And these in the back, well, it's alright to have three of them connected together, they should be the same width as well. And these pieces here should be rubber magnets. Now, outside of that, this is pretty close to how he had the patent set up. And the card I even built out of arc magnets with NEOs on the bottom here. So they're not the Elenkos like it calls for in the patent, but you get a pretty similar effect with them. As you see, it works. Just like his, it works either way you put this in here. Okay, here's essentially how this thing works. The magnets on the track are oriented basically like this. This is the actual patent rendering here. And to get this to function, you're going to have to mix up the type of magnets you use. You can't just do this all ceramic, it won't function. The key to making these work is the spin accelerators here. These are what crowd the magnetic spins into certain areas of the track and accelerate the cart as it goes down the track. Now these are made up basically, let's see, there's a NEO here, these are ceramic. These are ceramic in the front with NEO padding. These may be about at the half point, or they may be tipped with NEOs. It's not really clearly stated in the patent. These are rubber magnets here. And the actual magnets that go on the cart are NEO tipped. These are actually Elenko magnets. I believe they're Elenko 2s, but don't quote me without looking at the patent. Anyway, if you don't utilize this configuration here of the magnets, you're not going to get this thing to function the way Howard Johnson did. The different types of magnets create different types of spins and effects. If you just do this with one type, you're not going to get the same type of effect that he did. I'm going to break this down a little bit and explain this in a way that other people don't seem to be doing. A basic magnetic track, what they don't show you in most of the videos is they repel the cart at the opening of the track. You got to get past this first point of repulsion to get anything out of the track. And then of course it'll shoot through them. The other thing they don't show you is that there are areas where the track will still function if you start it out, but there are also these dead zones, also known as flux loops, areas of flux where the car will just stay there, it won't really do anything. Also stop the car at the end. Because what it's really doing, it's almost like one long magnet. You're getting past the repulsion at the end of it in order to attract to the end. There's really no mystery to that. It's how the magnets are placed that make it actually do something. And the real key to this, it won't work without the spin accelerators and without the correct types of magnets. You can't just do this with ceramics. This isn't how Howard Johnson intended it. This is kind of a basic setup just to demonstrate. funny thing is, it actually works better backwards. Okay, here's the completed version with the neodymium magnets built in. As you see, there's still a little repulsion at the opening of the gate. But after you put it into that opening piece, it shoots through quite easily. The other thing you can see with the neos, it doesn't stop so easily through the middle. You can actually see the spin accelerators firing as it goes through here. Which is why it wobbles back and forth. Another interesting note, if you turn this around backwards, you gotta get past these pieces here, obviously, because those are intended to be in the back of the array. But once you're past that, it actually kicks through with a lot more force when it comes out. You can see it just jerking back and forth as it goes through there, as it hits each spin accelerator. And I kind of wonder if maybe Howard Johnson deliberately put that backwards on the patent. You got to keep in mind he was a codebreaker for the U.S. government at one point. I could see him encrypting something in the patent. It wouldn't surprise me. And it clearly has more of a kick when it comes through the other way. Also, to show this is a little closer to how it is in the patent with the arced magnet. A lot of times, Howard would just kind of glue these things together out of other magnets, tip them with neos on the bottom there. And I just did this to show you that you get basically the same effect. Again, you can turn that around backwards and it's got a bit more of a kick. I just did this to kind of demonstrate that changing the magnets around, it works pretty much the same way. These magnets are just a little stronger than the other cart, so it's better for demonstration. But so anyway, that's it. That's the final version.